Discover Newport. Our good friends over there have been kind enough to bring us Chef Brigid Rafferty. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
You are from. Nice to see you. I love the name, The Power of Juice.
Yes.
As an admitted Back to the Future nerd, I might insert Juice for Love and come up with a whole song for you in tribute to you and Huey Lewis. Right. But today we're making protein nut milk and two other juices, aren't we?
Yes. We're going to make a protein nut milk, which is an organic cashew nut milk that I make, as well as one of my signature juices, which is Hot Stuff. That features pineapple, jalapeno, golden delicious apple, and yellow pepper, and also a pudding, a paleo-style chocolate mousse that I make that's made of avocado and some other yummy ingredients.
Hot Stuff, named after me.
Yeah.
Of course. Take us through some of the ingredients you have here.
The ingredients for the cashew nut milk, which is called protein nut, is organic raw cashews, double-fold vanilla, some organic Vermont maple syrup, organic cinnamon and flaky sea salt. For the paleo-style mousse, it's got an avocado base. Also in it is chia seeds, organic cold-pressed cacao, flaky sea salt, the same Vermont organic maple syrup and vanilla. And the ingredients for the Hot Stuff are right there as you see them. Nothing but fruits and vegetables, two different kinds of peppers, apple, and pineapple.
It all looks tremendous. I got to be honest with you. I can't wait to sample.
But it's yummy.
Absolutely. And you will take us through the steps. And people, we want them to come see you, but maybe they can tackle some of these juices at home.
Absolutely.
And you'll kind of simplify it for us. Because I think a lot of people might be a little bit intimidated if they've never tried this type of thing. But it's really very rudimentary. They don't need to be nervous.
Yeah, it's all about food prep, buying quality ingredients, and finding the right machine that works for you in your home environment.
All right, we will follow your lead this morning.
Thank
you. Chef Brigid Rafferty from The Power of Juice. I promise I won't sing. I know you want me to, but I won't. For now, we want to send it back over to you. Send it back into the kitchen. We'll take it away, sir.
That's right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Thanks to our friends at Discover Newport. Chef Brigid's here. The Power of Juice is the place, and we're going to make some, was it nut milk?
Yes.
That's what we're going to do.
Yes.
Okay. Take me through the process. And how does this taste, by the way? Tastes good?
It tastes like Christmas in a jar.
Look at
how can you
Christmas
argue with that?
In a jar? That's magical.
Yeah. Basically, a lot of people think that nut milks aren't available to them at home, but they are. All you really need is a blender to accomplish making a nut milk and a couple of raw ingredients.
Right.
I choose to use a Vitamix. It's got a lot more power than a regular blender, but it's pricey. If you have any kind of blender at home, you can still make nut milks. The key for me is I take raw organic nuts, if you can afford them, soak them for at least 4 hours, but my preferred method is up to 48.
Okay, now why are you soaking it? Does it soften them up a little bit?
It does two things. It does that, but the more important thing that it does is it neutralizes an enzyme that exists in raw nuts that some people can find really upsetting to their digestion.
Got it.
So basically, you soak the nuts, you take them out of the fridge. You always want to refrigerate the nuts when you soak them.
Mm-hmm.
You strain off the liquid. You can, if you want to be extra diligent, rinse the nuts again after that. But I soak mine in spring water. I never use tap water.
You're good.
If you're going to go through the effort of using raw organic ingredients, you should use fresh water as well that's clean. So you just add those to the water that I already measured into the blender, which is 40 ounces of water. It's important to fill the blender first with the water because otherwise the nuts will displace the water and you'll end up with the wrong amount.
Got it.
I add to it organic Vermont maple syrup.
So there really is flavor to this. So someone who's thinking, okay, there's not going to be any taste to this, there's not going to be any flavor to it. With that alone, with the syrup you're adding, that's good
stuff. Yes, and I choose syrup for anything that I have to sweeten because it's all natural, it's organic, and syrup is the only form of natural sweetener that actually has something in it that's good for you that isn't just sugar because there are minerals in maple syrup that are very beneficial to your health.
Got it.
Put flaky sea salt in there. It enhances flavor, but also, again, your body needs salt in order to absorb other nutrients. Cinnamon is important because a lot of people that are actually consuming my products are also juice fasting. Cinnamon is great for regulating
blood
sugar.
And the last ingredient that you're going to put in there is?
The last one is double-fold Madagascar vanilla.
Sounds good. All right, we're going to blend that up. And actually, this is the finished product. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Back to you. And thanks again to Discover Newport. Chef Brigid Rafferty is here. Power Juice is the place. We've got a lot of things going on. We're going to test out the juicer. You were telling me all about the juicer. But in the last segment, we made the milk.
Yes, cashew nut milk.
Cashew nut milk. So we're going to give this a shot.
Oh, here we go.
Here we go. And I love milk.
Do
you drink milk all the time?
I actually drink too much milk.
I think I may drink too much. She says Christmas in a jar, so we'll give it a shot.
That is hot. That is Christmas in a jar. I concur. That's terrific. Yeah. We were talking about Christmas earlier. It's perfect timing.
You know what's nice about this, too? It's not sometimes you'll have something like this and it tastes watery or something like that. This actually has a creamy consistency to it.
It's really good.
It's
frothy in a way.
It's good.
It's good.
That
so
I like.
You can use that. You can drink it the way that it is. You can put it on cereal. You can put it in iced coffee. You can use it as a base for your own smoothie at home. You can put it on granola. You can do. I've been making ice pops with it for my daughter and Azoku.
Probably adding coffee milk syrup. Probably.
No. That's just not the natural way.
Just a thought.
So what I'm going to have you do is use one of my preferred home juicers. If you're really want to go one level up for home juicing, it's an Omega. Champion also makes a very similar one. It's a single auger juicer. It gives you 24-hour shelf life, preserves the vitamins in the juice. All you have to do is cut the produce up into appropriate sizes to fit through the chute, turn it on, and
we'll power this up. Really doesn't make make that much sense.
I was all set to do my joke and be like, and what? But it's not at all. It's very soothing.
It's very soothing.
And these you said
one
I can.
The quieter juices.
And over here.
And that we are making a mousse that I call Not Your Mother's Mousse. It's a paleo style chocolate mousse. Mm-hmm. It's very heart healthy. It's full of, you know, avocados, the main ingredient. It has chia seeds and the other ingredients we mentioned earlier.
Sure.
Basically, we're just and stoning the avocados to put in, and then we'll have you add the other ingredients.
Now, am I dumping each one, the entire thing?
The whole thing. Runaway.
Runaway pit.
Runaway pit.
There we go.
Yeah, you're just going to dump them all right in there, and then we're going to turn it on, whizzy it up, and including the water that's in.
Outstanding. You give very good direction, I must say. A lot of times I'm lost in this kitchen.
Some people call me a little bossy.
No,
that's okay. So, Bridget,
it's not a bad thing.
If someone really wants to, you know, find out more about the business or meet up with you, I know you're at a bunch of different, locations.
Yeah,
as well,
I have a really informative website that gives a lot of FAQs and all the answers about juicing. Why would you want to juice? How do you want to juice? What are the different juicing machines you can use? And that's at www.thepowerofjuice.com. I'm also in Middletown at a farmer's market every Saturday from 9 to 1 at the Aquidnert Growers Market at Newport Winery. I'm in my store every day of the week at 796 Aquidneck Avenue in Middletown.
Perfect.
Now you
stand back, everybody.
Turn it on.
Turn it on. You know what? I want to spin this around because I want to show
everybody.
So we're
going to let it go for a little bit to get it creamy and then stop it after
it's doing its thing in there. I like that it's transparent. You can keep your eye on all angles of it. It works really well.
I want to spin this around just a little bit, too. Just so everybody sees how this is coming out.
Everything smells great.
Stop it now and just lift the lid off and give it a little bit of a stir to get the avocado.
There you go. And you work it around in there.
Yeah.
And they really
are. You want it to be really smooth?
Sure.
So many benefits to the juice.
Oh, yes. Health, of course.
So this one is one of my more popular flavors. It's right here. It's called Hot Stuff.
Okay.
It's got pineapple in it, which is really great for chest congestion. It's nature's cough syrup. If you have a kid and they have a cold, you should be getting them full chunks of pineapple to chew on. It soothes their throat. No chemicals there. Organic apples and peppers, and the jalapeno pepper, which all peppers are good for you metabolically, but also the thermogenics, which help you burn fat.
Right.
Love
a lot
it.
Of people that are juicing are trying to be trim and healthy as well.
I want to try some of the chocolate.
Sure, get in there.
Yeah, just so while I have a chocolate mousse for you gentlemen to share, I will give you both a spoon. And,
how lovely to share this chocolate mousse.
It's our first share of chocolate mousse together.
You brought us together.
Oh, yeah.
Gonna give this a taste.
And I think.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, we want to thank you for joining us. We're still kind of working things around, but we'll be happy to sample. If you guys would like any of Chef Brigid's fine recipes, three different types of juice, Will loves every single one of them. Thanks for being here.
This is so good.
And it's good for you.
All right, more information at Rhode Show, rhodeshow.com.